So I'd like to show you guys the latest LRP racing speed control that we have developed over the last month. It's called the Flow, as you can see on the aluminum heatsink. It's a brand new design. The footprint is the same as the old one. Also, where the wires exit is the same. But this is about where the similarities end. All the electronics, so the hardware and the software, is brand new. And yeah, let me highlight a few of the features. As you can see, it's extensively machined aluminum parts. Its construction hasn't done that way before. It's a sandwich. This is the power board. This is like a middle board, and the power board is sandwiched between two aluminum parts, so the thermal transfer is really, really good to the case, which means the operating temperature inside is very low. And then from the bottom side, the logic board is plugged in, and then everything closes with a plastic bottom case. So this is one of the main advantages of the speed control, that it runs cooler. Which in 12 scale is not really that much of an issue with the existing speed control, but in other classes such as touring car, which we will see later on this week, the cooling is very important because the braking power and the horsepower we have nowadays is massive. So getting the temperature out of the inside of the speed control is important. We have now also more fine-tuning possibilities, that people can adjust the profiles more fine, the angle, the boost, the turbo. We still use the flashes to adjust it, so it's a fast trackside adjustment without a computer required. But obviously you can update the software with the computer if there is new software available. One other neat feature is that we have U-taps now for the power PCB, like on the motor. You can now put the wires in more easily than on the old one, where you had to wiggle them through the PCB. You simply solder them from the side, which is much easier. So we had the official debut here at the 12 scale world championships in Holland, and most of the guys, of the official team guys, have switched to the Flow speed control at the race. Obviously we started, Ronald ran it at first, and Vesa and Daniel Sieber were testing it prior to the race and felt it was very, very good, and so we used their base setup to start, and everybody's satisfied, and so I am as well.